SpaceX never fails to surprise the world. Since the launch of Raptor 3, Elon Musk's company has once again pushed the boundaries of rocket technology. But this engine is no mere upgrade. It has evolved into one of the most powerful rocket engines ever built. And what's even more interesting is what we haven't seen yet. Behind the scenes, SpaceX has been quietly developing something even more ambitious, Raptor 4, an engine designed to take space exploration to a whole new level and potentially leave other worlds decades behind. Let's talk more in today's episode of NR Studio. On August 3, 2024, SpaceX made waves in the aerospace community by officially launching Raptor 3, the result of years of research and iteration. It wasn't just the sleeker design that stood out, but also the significant leap in performance over its predecessors, Raptor 1 and 2. It exemplified SpaceX's engineering philosophy: learn fast, improve fast, and reduce complexity wherever possible. As Elon Musk often says, the best part is no parts. In other words, eliminating unnecessary components makes things not only simpler, but also more reliable. Raptor 3 emphasizes efficiency and power. It's now flown on some of Starship's final test flight, as of prototypes Ship 37 and 38. But attention is quickly turning to the next generation Starship, Ship 39, teased by Musk during a recent Mars update. Standing more than 180 feet tall with a massive 1,550-ton propellant capacity, Ship 39 retains its three vacuum engine and three sea level engine configuration. What's really surprising is its thrust, 1,600 tons, nearly 200 more than the previous block. With that kind of power, it's expected to launch 100 to 120 tons into low Earth orbit, roughly the equivalent of 60 Starlink V3 satellites in a single shot. But SpaceX's vision extends far beyond Earth orbit. To truly colonize Mars, Starship will need to handle missions lasting 6 to 8 months and carrying hundreds of tons of payloads, ranging from habitat modules to life support systems and crew. Such a mission would require performance beyond what the Raptor 3 could offer. While it already has an impressive 350 seconds of specific impulse, a long-duration mission would ideally require 380 to 400 seconds to maximize fuel efficiency. That's where the Raptor 4 comes in, though it hasn't been officially announced yet. The first hint came during an interview between Elon Musk and Everyday Astronaut, where Musk casually mentioned a future engine capable of producing 330 tons of thrust, a marked jump from the Raptor 3's 280 tons. In the same Mars presentation, Musk talked about a future Starship capable of launching up to 300 tons of cargo per flight, 100 tons more than the current design. To make that happen, a much more powerful engine would be essential. So what makes the Raptor 4 so special? First, there's its incredible power. Weighing in at 330 tons, the aircraft will be 17% more powerful than the Raptor 3. By comparison, a single Raptor 4 engine will produce nearly half the thrust of the legendary F1 engine used on the Saturn V. However, the real improvement lies in efficiency. With a target-specific impulse of 380 seconds, Raptor 4 would be significantly more fuel-efficient than the F1, 304 seconds, allowing spacecraft to travel farther while carrying more payload. Scale that up, put 33 Raptor 4s on a super heavy booster, and you're looking at liftoff thrust of around 10,890 tons, more than three times what the Saturn V could deliver. And the Starship upper stage could someday feature six vacuum Raptors and three sea-level Raptors, combining for around 3,000 tons of thrust just in orbit. But Raptor 4 isn't just about raw power. It's also about refinement. Raptor 3 already pushes chamber pressure to 350 bar, the highest of any active engine. Raptor 4 is expected to raise that even further to around 380 bar, with an estimated 7.9% increase in fuel efficiency. In the vacuum of space, that level of optimization makes a huge difference. For the same orbital maneuver, Raptor 4 could save over 90 liters of propellant, freeing up weight for extra cargo or additional delta-V margin. One of the biggest advantages of Raptor 4 will be its simplified design. With Raptor 3, SpaceX already cut down the number of parts dramatically, speeding up manufacturing and reducing failure points.
Raptor 4 is expected to streamline things even further. Fewer seals, fewer fasteners, fewer components that can fail. That means higher reliability, faster production cycles, and lower costs across the board. And production speed matters. Raptor 1 took 11 days to build. Raptor 2 cut that down to 2 days. Raptor 3 brought it to 1. With the lessons learned, Raptor 4 could potentially be manufactured even faster. SpaceX isn't at full production yet, but progress is steady. As of May 20, the 20th Raptor 3 had already been spotted in the wild just under a year after the first one was completed. Over 300 test firings and 16,000 seconds of burn time have already been logged at McGregor, showing how aggressively SpaceX is validating the design. Now let's talk cost. Elon Musk has stated a long-term goal of producing Raptor engines for under $250,000 each. While that's extremely ambitious, it may not be impossible. Raw materials alone, like high-nickel superalloys, can cost over $100,000. Add complex components, like engine controllers and cryogenic sensors, plus testing and certification, and the total cost adds up fast. But with high-volume production and design simplification, the cost curve will eventually come down. A more realistic near-term number for Raptor 4 may be around $500,000, which is still revolutionary compared to traditional engines. So is Raptor 4 real? All signs point to yes. Though it hasn't officially debuted, Musk have been dropping hints since 2024. It's very likely that SpaceX has a skunkworks-style development team working on early prototypes, just like Apple building the next iPhone behind the scenes while the current one is still on shelves.
For now, the spotlight remains on Raptor 3, with its first full-scale launches expected later this year. That includes one of SpaceX's most daring plans yet, catching both stages of Starship using the Mechazilla Tower for the first time. After that, attention will shift to in-orbit refueling, a key step towards sustained lunar and Martian missions. Once those systems are proven, SpaceX will begin flying uncrewed demo flights of the lunar Starship, laying the foundation for future crewed landings on the moon. And someday soon, Starship will bring humans back to the lunar surface, more than half a century after Apollo. With every new engine iteration, SpaceX isn't just building rockets, it's building the future, one step closer to making humanity a multiplanetary species. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next episode.